Hello aspirants, welcome to MPPSC Adda. We are here bringing you the lecture series on current affairs related to Madhya Pradesh. It's a lecture series called MP365 because we are covering current affairs of Madhya Pradesh of last 1 year, and we are bringing you the most important facts and news which you need to remember for exam. For all the courses, for prelims test series, for our current affairs, for our main test series, you can log on to www.mppsc.com and you can get all the important information regarding prelims test series and main test series. We are also providing mentorship in main. You can go and browse our program details. You can also download our app MPPSC Adda from Google Play, and you can check all the courses there also, and you can subscribe to that. Let's start with the series on current affairs related to Madhya Pradesh. It's very important that first thing we need to understand that exam is just few days away, and till then it's very important to retain so many facts you have read since last 1 year, but in the last time it's very important to revise them again and again so that you can recall it in the exam hall. As you know that exam is very factual, that's why I will just summarize all the important things in terms of facts. And sometimes I will also cover some basic GK facts that are in news, that is related to some news, okay, so that you can be very thorough with everything, whether it's history, geography or polity. Let's start with our first news and first important topic to understand, that modern international cargo hub is dedicated in which city. It's a very important fact. It can be asked in exam with four options of four cities. You should always take Indore, okay? Modern International Cargo Hub. You can also remember it like that Indore business capital or mini Mumbai, okay? So it will be coming in Indore. Next thing is Kolar Reservoir. Kolar Reservoir, it will be developed like Hanuvantia. It was in news sometimes back. Kolar Reservoir is on Kolar River. Important thing to remember is Kolar River is a tributary of Narmada River. Developed like Hanuvantia. What is Hanuvantia? Hanuvantia is a tourist spot on the banks of Indra Sagar Dam. Where is Indra Sagar Dam located? It's located in Khandwa district. Why is it very important? Because also Jal Mahotsav is celebrated in Hanuvantia. Another important fact, Hanuvantia is also called as Switzerland of Madhya Pradesh. So three facts, very, very important connected to this news. One thing is Kolar River. Kolar River is a tributary of Narmada. Kolar Dam is very near to Bhopal. Second thing, Hanuvantia, called as Switzerland of MP, famous for Jal Mahotsav, and also located on the bank of Indra Sagar Dam. And obviously, Indra Sagar Dam is on Narmada River. Okay, let's move on to the next news. Forest of Madhya Pradesh. It's regarding the forest of Madhya Pradesh. Who is our forest minister? Our forest minister is Shri Kuvar Vijay Shah. What happened recently is that Andaman and Nicobar government has given rupees 500 crore to Madhya Pradesh for planting trees. Why did that happen? It happened because Madhya Pradesh has taken many initiatives like Buffer Mein Safar, Night Safari in Pech, Bandhavgarh and Satpura. Also initiatives like hot balloons. Because of these initiatives, MP government has got funding from Andaman and Nicobar government. Madhya Pradesh, which was earlier only the tiger state or Ghadiyal state, is going to get the title of leopard state also. Next important news, Health Minister Vishwas Kailash Sarang has recently declared that old Hawa Mahal situated in Hamidia Hospital Complex will be removed for increasing capacity of hospital beds. It can be asked in exam, what does old Hawa Mahal refers to? It is not any heritage building. It's related to like Hamidia Hospital Complex building. So don't get confused. Next topic is Trimbakeshwar. Chief Minister Shivraj Singh Chauhan recently visited Trimbakeshwar near Nasik. It was in news. Trimbakeshwar, why is it important? Because it's one of the Jyotirling located where in Maharashtra. Regarding Jyotirlings, two important Jyotirlings are very important, which are located in Madhya Pradesh. Total are 12, two are in MP. What are they? One thing is Mahakaleshwar, located in Ujjain. Second one is Omkareshwar in Khandwa district. Please remember that it's very probable that these kind of facts can be asked in exam. So be clear, two Jyotirlings in MP, Mahakaleshwar and Omkareshwar, not Maheshwar. Okay, Mahakaleshwar in Ujjain district on the banks of Shipra river and Omkareshwar in Khandwa district on the banks of Narmada river. Also, Mahakaleshwar is south facing Jyotirling. Question can also be asked like that. Which of the following Jyotirlings is facing south? So answer would be Mahakaleshwar. Next news is Beti Bachao Abhiyan. Save the girl child and educate the girl child. Beti Padhao Abhiyan. It's a central government scheme launched in 2015. Very important fact. It has been asked in MPPSC prelims exam earlier about the major flagship scheme in which year they have been started. Okay, regarding Beti Bachao Abhiyan, it started in 2015. What happened recently that Beti Bachao Abhiyan was launched afresh in the start with new vigor, new initiatives and new goals. Regarding the history, it started in 2015 and regarding the campaign and its objective, attention to every aspect of the girl child, its birth, its education, security and empowerment. Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao, save the girl child, educate the girl child related to every aspect of girl child like birth, education, security and employment. Madhya Pradesh is the first state in the country to implement the integrated management program of severely malnourished children in the state. So it's very important that MP is the one of the first states in the country who has started integrated management program of severely malnourished children in the state with the motto Poshit Parivar, Suposhit Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh government has also started nutrition dashboard for monitoring nutrition services. Next thing is nutrition policy. It's under the drafting stage. Nutrition policy of Madhya Pradesh is also coming in next few months. Next important news is Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana. Madhya Pradesh ranked first in its implementation. It's very probable question, it can be asked in exam. What is the rank of Madhya Pradesh in implementation of Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana? Your answer would be ranked 1. 150% achievement has been made under this scheme. What does this scheme related to? This scheme is related to self-help groups. Self-help groups were recently appreciated at a program organized by Panchayat and Rural Development. Why? Because they helped in empowering girls and women through self-help groups and work is being done to benefit them through other schemes. So, Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana, again for the empowerment of girls and women and basically with the help of self-help groups. Let's move on to the next news. Khelo India Games of 2022 is going to held in Bhopal. MP government has recently got in principle approval for Khelo India Games 2022 to be held in Bhopal. Okay. Recently, two players of Madhya Pradesh won Olympic quota in shooting, whose name are Pinky Yadav and Aishwarya Pratap Singh. Remember their names. MPPC is asking these kind of facts related to sports. So these facts are very probable to come in examination. Pinky Yadav and Aishwarya Pratap Singh, they have won Olympic quota in shooting. In shooting. Okay. Similarly, 25 sports persons of the state are getting trained as Olympic qualifiers. So Khelo India Games 2022 going to be held in Bhopal. We have got in principle approval. Next fact you need to remember, Khelo India Games 2021, what was the key aspect related to that? That yoga was included in. Yoga has been a sport in Khelo India Games 2021. Okay. Also in 2021, many Vivekananda Yoga centers started in district level for the expansion of yoga in the state. MP government has taken this initiative. For the history of Khelo India Games, first event held in 2019, last one held in 2020. Its purpose is grassroots talent hunt. What is the purpose of Khelo India Games? Purpose is grassroots talent hunt. Just Just remember this word, and it's headquartered in New Delhi. So this is the whole facts you need to remember regarding Khelo India Games. So whenever the question comes for Khelo India Games 19, 20 or 21, and who are the Olympic qualifiers, who got the Olympic quota in shooting, two students, two sports persons, you need to remember that. Again, some sports academy were in news, like Men's Hockey Academy. It will be re-established in Bhopal. Women's Hockey Academy in Gwalior to promote hockey. Martial Arts Academy, again Bhopal. And Shooting Range, again Bhopal. So Bhopal and Gwalior, new sports academies are coming. You need to remember this. They can simply ask, Men's Hockey Academy will be re-established in which of the following cities? Bhopal, Gwalior, Indore or Jabalpur? Your answer should be Bhopal. Similarly, some of the sports complexes are also proposed, like International Sports Complex in Gwalior, World Class Sports Science Center in Bhopal, World Class Archery Infrastructure in Jabalpur, and Multipurpose Sports Complex at Bijalpur, Indore. So Indore, Jabalpur, Gwalior, Bhopal, these all four different cities. In all those cities, sports complexes are proposed. So remember this fact from the sports section of Madhya Pradesh. These facts can come definitely in exam. Now, very important topic, Kane Betwa interlinking project. This news has been very much in the newspapers and through MP government or through national level news. First important fact related to that is Union Jal Shakti Minister. Who is he? Gajendra Singh Shekhawat. Single liner fact you need to remember. Next thing is, who are the states involved? Madhya Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh. The two states are involved in Kane Betwa interlinking project. Madhya Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh. Important dam on Kane River. Dodhan Dam. It was in news many times. You need to remember that Dodhan Dam is on Kane River. You can see on the map, Kane River, Dodhan Dam, here Betwa River, and this is Kane Betwa interlinking project. Okay, so Kane River, Betwa River, interlinking project, Dodhan Dam on Kane River, two states involved, Madhya Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh. Next important fact is, when was this Kane Betwa link multi-purpose link project proposed? 2009. Important point to remember, Kane Betwa interlinking project was declared and started in 2009. Important districts of Madhya Pradesh involved in this project are Chhatarpur, Panna and Tikamgarh. From the Madhya Pradesh side, was sharing border with Uttar Pradesh, these three districts are involved in Kane Betwa interlinking project. Here you can see that this project is for the development of Bundelkhand region. And three districts, Chhatarpur, Panna and Tikamgarh, are involved in that. But from the Uttar Pradesh side, which are the three districts which are involved? Khasi, Mahoba and Banda. These are the three districts of Uttar Pradesh which are related to Kane Betwa interlinking project. Next thing is, multipurpose Kane Betwa project is made in sequence of former Prime Minister, late Shri Atal Bihari Vajpayee's Nadi Jodo campaign. It was in sequence with the Nadi Jodo campaign proposed 20 years back during the tenure of Atal Bihari Vajpayee as the Prime Minister. Next important news related to Madhya Pradesh is, MP leads in implementation of Atal Groundwater Scheme. As the name suggests, it's a scheme related to providing quality groundwater to improve the quality of groundwater of Madhya Pradesh. And six districts are included in this scheme, which are they? Chhatarpur, Sagar, Tikamgarh, Damoh, Panna and Niwadi. These six districts are focused for what? Atal groundwater scheme. So you need to remember, just six districts are involved in Atal groundwater scheme. Next, what is the targeted year for completion of this scheme is 2025. Similarly, like when we are talking about Atmanirbhar Madhya Pradesh, what is the target year set by Madhya Pradesh government? It's 2023. For this scheme, the target is 2025. Who is funding this project? World Bank and Government of India. This is very important fact. This can be asked in exam. It's very probable. Who is funding Atal Groundwater Scheme? Answer is World Bank and Government of India. Let's see what is Jal Jeevan Mission. Jal Jeevan Mission is one of the flagship program. It aims for tap connections in every house and to provide clean and pure water. What its target? 16 crore tap connections that are to be given in the next 5 years across the country. This is regarding Jal Jeevan Mission. Basic facts to retain. Madhya Pradesh target to provide tap water by 2023 to 1 crore houses. These are very factual information, but you need to remember them because you will get options like this. What is the target of Madhya Pradesh government to provide tap water to 1 crore houses and by what time? These targets are set under Jal Jeevan Mission. And what is the target related to per person per day? 55 liters per person per day. That is the target of the government to be achieved by 2023. It is in sync with Atmanirbhar Madhya Pradesh target year. Next important aspect regarding the COVID-19 vaccination. World's largest vaccination campaign started from January 16th. Remember this date? On January 16th, the campaign for vaccination started for vaccines Covishield and Covaxin. What is the name of digital platform for monitoring vaccination work? Answer is Covin. Covaxin and Covishield, they are the name of the vaccine. Covin is the name of the platform. Don't get confused among these three terms. A person who is vaccinated will be given a digital certificate. As you have seen, whoever is getting vaccinated will get a certificate that the first dose is over, and they will get a tentative date for the second dose. And after the second dose, they will also get final certificate. Okay. So things to remember, Covin is a digital platform. As apps and web portals are very important and more probable to come in the examination, you should remember that. Covin and two vaccines, Covishield and Covaxin. What is the helpline number 1075 and 104? Not very probable to come in exam. Just to mention central helpline number and state government helpline number. Samman, a campaign for women safety in Madhya Pradesh. What its objective? To ensure active participation of the society for eradication of crime against women, respectful and favorable environment, common people aware of the legal provisions so that they are able to ensure the safety of women. The Samman campaign is related to, the question can be asked like this. So it's related to safety of women. Next, very important news. Omkareshwar solar floating energy plant. What is its capacity? Simple and basic question, it can be asked in exam. Its capacity is 600 megawatt. Okay. Next important fact, who is the new and renewable energy minister? Hardeep Singh Dang. He was in news so much that you need to remember this fact. World's largest solar floating plant, this is, which is coming in Omkareshwar with the capacity 600 megawatt. What is the proposed site for that? Omkareshwar Sagar in Khandwa district. Khandwa district has become a prominent power hub in few years. You need to remember that. Omkareshwar Sagar in Khandwa district. Indira Sagar also in Khandwa district. Don't confuse between them. They are different and they both are in Khandwa district. Let's see some facts about Omkareshwar Sagar project. Commission date July 2023. Reason for project, that water level of Indira Sagar and Omkareshwar Sagar is almost constant in all the seasons. That's why they have targeted Omkareshwar Sagar as the place for this energy plant. This place is developed as a multi-purpose project like power production, tourism, water conservation and land conservation. Next is Indrasagar Dam. Again, I have told you, Indrasagar Dam, multi-purpose project on Narmada River, near Punasa in Khandwa district. What are the downstream projects after Indrasagar? Omkareshwar, Maheshwar and Sardar Sarovar project along the downstream of Narmada River. Just remember these facts, these are very important. If you arrange in sequence, first Indrasagar will come, then Omkareshwar, then Maheshwar and then Sardar Sarovar. What is the India's non-renewable energy target? Its target is 175 gigawatt. It was very much in news, very important. Just retain this in mind, 175 gigawatt by 2022. When we talk about Madhya Pradesh, we have added 5 gigawatt. Any 5000 megawatt renewable energy projects have been set up in Madhya Pradesh. And with time, Khandwa is emerging as a power hub with total of 800 megawatt, which is maximum in any district of Madhya Pradesh. Keep that in mind, it can be asked. Maximum power hub or maximum power generation in a single district of Madhya Pradesh, answer would be. Next important point is, Pradhan Mantri formalization of micro food processing enterprises scheme has been approved for implementation. Where? In Madhya Pradesh. It's a centrally sponsored scheme. Year for that is 2020-21 to 2024-25. Allocated fund. And the scheme is based on Ek Jila Ek Utpad. It's very, very important. Future lectures, in coming lectures, we will see what are the various products which have been assigned under Ek Jila Ek Utpad scheme. January 12th, National Youth Day. This question is very probable. National Youth Day is celebrated on which date? Answer is 12th of January. Reason for that, it's the birthday of Swami Vivekananda. Swami Vivekananda spread yoga to the masses. His message was Vedant philosophy, and he gave the Chicago address in 1893. This fact has been come in exam earlier also. It's very important. 1893, just remember, he was born in 1863. Only at the age of 20 years, he was given the Chicago address in World Parliament of Religions. Green signal to Sri Mahakal Vikas Yojana. Sri Mahakal Vikas Yojana, it's a scheme for the development of Mahakaleshwar. Jyotirlings, we have seen earlier, Mahakaleshwar and Omkareshwar, Shipra River and Narmada River, Ujjain district and Khandwa district. Maheshwar, again remember, don't confuse, Maheshwar is not a Jyotirling. It's located in Khargone district and not a Bhamashah Yojana, it was in news sometimes. You just need to remember that Bhamashah Yojana is related to taxpayers, honest taxpayers. Bhamashah Yojana will be restarted to encourage honest taxpayers in the new financial year. And at the end of the financial year, selected taxpayers would be rewarded. Whenever you see Bhamashah Yojana in the question paper, just tick honest taxpayers. These are some of the resolutions taken by Madhya Pradesh government, like 12 principles of governance, like welfare of people scheme of poor, Atmanirbhar Madhya Pradesh and Atmanirbhar Bharat, in line with that, and targeting 2023, development of farmers, women empowerment and good governance. These are the few important points Madhya Pradesh government is targeting. It Atmanirbhar Madhya Pradesh. What is the major task which MP government is targeting in 2021? Single citizen database for all beneficiaries, electronic signal single windows, implementation of Rozgar Setu portal. It's very important to meet the goals of Atmanirbhar Madhya Pradesh. Very important fact, Atmanirbhar Madhya Pradesh roadmap has been designed by partnering with IIM Indore. It's fact in mind. It's very probable to come in examination. Use of dashboard for monitoring of district level task and to implement the concept of CM Rise School. We'll see what is it all about. Again, Academy of Administration, to make it a high level training institute, to increase capital expenditure, grant of forest right to tribal communities, and minimum government and maximum governance. These are the target of Madhya Pradesh government to get Atmanirbhar. Vaccination is started from which place? Answer is Singrauli. The work of vaccination for prevention against corona infection has been started at trauma center Singrauli. Okay. Date 16 January. Vaccination campaign started on January 16th. We have seen in the earlier slides also. Where was it started? Singrauli. Okay. Pradhan Mantri Swanidhi Yojana. Madhya Pradesh pioneer in Pradhan Mantri Swanidhi Yojana. Madhya Pradesh started Swanidhi Yojana on its own. Who is the Union Finance Minister? Nirmala Sitaraman. Remember this fact. Nirmala Sitaraman is the Union Minister. Madhya Pradesh is the pioneer in Pradhan Mantri Swanidhi Yojana. Let's see what is it. Pradhan Mantri Swanidhi Yojana is Pradhan Mantri Street Vendor Self-Reliant Fund. It's named as Swanidhi Yojana, launched by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Beneficiaries are street vendors. Very important fact, this scheme, Swanidhi, is related to street vendors. Launched on 1st June 2020, and its objective is central government will provide short-term loans up to 10,000 to hawkers and ready laborers. For the street vendors, it's a scheme for their welfare. What will be provided to them? Yearly Samman Nidhi of rupees 6,000 has been given to the farmers, and Samman Nidhi of 4,000 is given by the state government. So central and state both are contributing. Mahila Samman Abhiyan. It's a Run for Dignity campaign. It was started in Madhya Pradesh. Also, Madhya Pradesh has passed the Freedom of Religion Bill, which has been passed by the state government for the protection of girls and women. Very important fact, the Freedom of Religion Bill passed by the Madhya Pradesh government for the protection of girls and women. This is a very important fact. It can be a one-liner question coming prelims examination. Recently, a bridge is proposed on Son River. Where is it proposed? In Bihari, in Shahdol district. Bihari Vijay Sota Bridge. This bridge was in new. Bihari is an assembly constituency located in Shahdol district. And this is dedicated construction of a bridge of Vijay Sota on Son River in Bihari Katni Road. Okay, Bihari in Shahdol district. Bridge is proposed on Son River. Just remember this fact. Aapke Dwar Pahuncha Haridwar program. This program was in new. It's an initiative by Dev Sanskriti Vishwavidyalaya Haridwar. Our Chief Minister Shivraj Singh Chauhan was integrating with this university, and they launched the campaign to promote Sanatan Dharma on the Golden Jubilee year and Kumbh Mahaparv in 2021. So the scheme's taglines, Aapke Dwar Pahuncha Haridwar, Har Har Gange, Har Har Gange. So these are the key terms which was in news. Just need to mind. It's related to the promotion of Sanatan Dharma. Very important news. A new railway line started, a new train started from Rewa to Kevadia. Kevadia, which place is this? Where the Statue of Unity has recently inaugurated. So PM Shri Modi and Shri Chauhan flags off railway facility for Statue of Unity from 8 places. One of the places, Rewa. Important point, where is this Statue of Unity located? Place is called as Kevadia, located in Gujarat. Okay. Which district? Narmada district. There is a district named Narmada in Gujarat. Within that district, Kevadia is a place where Statue of Unity is located. Kevadia is recently becoming the world's biggest tourist destination because of world's highest statue, the Statue of Unity, Zoological Park, Jungle Safari, Arogya Forest, Nutrition Park, Glow Garden, Cactus Garden and Butterfly Park. All this has been developed in that area to promote tourism and to promote the idea of Ek Bharat, Shreshth Bharat. Aapka Sambal, Aapki Sarkar. During the whole Corona period, you would have heard about Sambal Yojana again and again. And on January 19, recently, Aapka Sambal, Aapki Sarkar initiative was again started. Recently, Chief Minister distributed fund to Sambal beneficiaries. Who are the beneficiaries? What is the eligibility for that? We will see. Eligibility for Sambal Yojana is unorganized workers. Unorganized workers are the targeted group for Sambal Yojana. Next important fact is, what are the benefits they are getting under Jan Kalyan Sambal Yojana? The benefits they are getting it: maternity facility, education, health insurance, waiver of electricity bill, providing better agricultural product, providing funeral support, benefit of Ayushman Bharat Yojana, and no fee will have to be paid if you have a new Savera card. We will see what this card is. So these are the benefits provided under Sambal Yojana to the beneficiaries, and beneficiaries are mostly unorganized workers. What does it provide? It provides for ex gratia on the normal death up to 2 lakh. These facts are very important. Can be asked in examination. Ex gratia on accidental death, 4 lakh. Partial permanent disability, they are providing 1 lakh. For permanent disability, they are providing 2 lakh. Funeral aid amount is 5,000 and maternity assistance up to 14,000. They have divided and categorized for the cash support for all the situations. Super 5,000 scheme, it is a part of Sambal Yojana. What is it? 5,000 children of Sambal families, they will be targeted. Who will get the highest number in 12th? They will get a separate amount of rupees 30,000. So whenever you see the term super 5,000 scheme, it's related to Sambal, related to unorganized worker families and their kids. The children who are getting highest number in 12th class, they are getting financial support of 30,000 rupees. Under Sambal Yojana, children of Sambal families who will participate in national level sports competitions will be given 50,000 rupees. This is regarding highest number in 12th, and this is regarding the sports competition. Okay, here it is 50,000, here it is 30,000. Fact in mind. Recently, Panna Diamond Mines lease period has been extended. Panna Diamond Mine in Panna district of Madhya Pradesh. Who is operating it? It's operated by National Mineral Development Corporation. National Mineral Development Corporation, where is it headquartered? In Hyderabad. So two, three important facts here coming. Panna Diamond Mine in Panna in Madhya Pradesh. It's a basic fact. It is operated by National Mineral Development Corporation. Where is this headquartered? It's headquartered in Hyderabad and it's working under Ministry of Steel. Recently, government has proposed medical institutions. Hospitals are proposed in Chhatarpur and Damoh on the line of AIIMS, and medical college is proposed in Sivni district. This fact is very important. The question is asked, recently a medical college is proposed in which of the following districts? Answer would be Sivni. If hospitals proposed on the lines of AIIMS, Chhatarpur and Damoh. Recently a personality was in news, Ustad Ghulam Mustafa Khan. Famous personality associated with Indian music industry, and he trained thousands of singers including Queen of Melody, Lata Mangeshkar. So one important fact, Lata Mangeshkar is also known as Queen of Melody, and Ustad Ghulam Mustafa Khan is related to the music. It can become in the exam with the options music, dance, drama, theater, something like that. So just remember, Indian music industry is related to, and he has trained our queen. Next scheme was in news is Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Rojgar Abhiyan. Important fact, again, Hardeep Singh Dang was in news related to this. New and renewable energy was very frequently, just remember, is related to renewable energy. Now, Madhya Pradesh is leading in the country by installing maximum number of solar pumps under the Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Abhiyan. So it's a basic question which will come into your mind. How new and renewable energy is helping Garib Kalyan? Okay, it's through solar pumps. Madhya Pradesh is leading in the country by installing maximum number of solar pumps under the Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Abhiyan. I'm repeating the facts for each point again and again so that it will be for you to remember. It was launched for migrant laborers who returned to their states during COVID. The targeted group is the migrant laborer who returned to their states during COVID. Okay, these are the 2-3 facts which are very important. Again, renewable energy, Hardeep Singh Dang, through solar pumps, they are doing Garib Kalyan. Who are those people? Who are the beneficiaries? Migrant laborers. Next is Rojgar Utsav program celebrated on January 20th. What is its purpose for youth employment? Rojgar Utsav related to employment. What does it do? Atmanirbhar Madhya Pradesh. It supports Atmanirbhar Madhya Pradesh. Now recently the statue of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose was inaugurated in Gotegaon. Where is it, Gotegaon? Gotegaon is in Narsingpur district. Remember this fact, Gotegaon is in Narsingpur district, and on the 125th birth anniversary of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, a statue was unveiled at Gotegaon. Okay, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose 125th birth anniversary, statue inaugurated, unveiled, where? Gotegaon, Narsingpur district. Let's see some of the facts related to this news. On Netaji's birthday, on 23rd January, we also celebrate Parakram Day. Very important point you need to remember, Parakram Day is celebrated on 23rd of January on the birth anniversary of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. Again, in Jaipur Central Jail Complex, one more statue has been installed on the occasion of Parakram Day. Also, the convention center is coming in Jabalpur, based on his name, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose Convention Center. Ek Jila Ek Utpad, this is the fact regarding to the Jabalpur city, also called as Sanskar Dhani. Very important, a very basic fact related to Jabalpur. Which city of Madhya Pradesh is Sanskar Dhani? Cultural capital of Madhya Pradesh. Regarding Ek Jila Ek Utpad, we have seen in the earlier slides, what is the product related to Jabalpur? Peas have been selected for Jabalpur. Just remember this, under Ek Jila Ek Utpad, peas have been selected with from Jabalpur district. Okay, Jabalpur also called a Sanskar Dhani. One convention center coming with the name Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose Convention Center, and also one of the statue was unveiled there on Parakram Day in Central. Let's see some of the facts regarding Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. He was born in 1897 and died in 1945. He joined Indian National Congress in 1921. Again, बहुत basic fact है जो मैं आप सबको बता रहा हूँ यहाँ पे. He also started a newspaper called Swaraj, and he was the president of the All India Youth Congress and also the secretary to Bengal State. He authored the book The Indian Struggle. Very important fact, who authored the book Indian Struggle? Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, which covers the Indian independence movement from 1920 to 1942. Two facts regarding Netaji. He started the newspaper Swaraj. He authored the book The Indian Struggle. He joined the International Congress 1921. His birthday is 23rd January. Birthday celebrated as Parakram Day. He coined the term Jai Hind. This is a very important point to remember for the examination. As I have told you, I am not covering only the current affairs. I am also covering the basic facts that are related to the current. So Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, Parakram Day, he coined the term Jai Hind. He was the president of Congress in 1938 and 1939. 1939 session of Congress was the Tripuri session, but he resigned from the presidentship of this Tripuri session. He was sent to prison in Mandalay. He also formed All India Forward Bloc in 1939. It's a very important fact which comes in. When was All India Forward Bloc created? 1939. He led Azad Hind Fauj from 1943 to 45. Azad Hind Fauj, first it was under the leadership of Captain Mohan. And then later in 1943, Azad Hind Fauj was taken over by Netaji Subhash Chandra. Some news related to the software sector. Software Development Center is coming by Wipro Group in Bhopal. Who is opening? Azim Premji Foundation. Establish a university in Madhya Pradesh. Wipro Group is going to open a university in Bhopal. Azim Premji Foundation is supporting that. Again, one personality who was in New Naren Chanchal. Naren Chanchal can be asked in exam is related to. He was a bhajan singer and he was in New because of his diploma. Let it mind. January 24th, Punk campaign was launched. We have seen earlier Samman campaign, Run for Dignity campaign. Again, one more campaign regarding National Girl, related to National Girl Child Day or girls, empowerment of girls. Punk campaign, National Girl Child Day, January 24th. So it's in sequence, National Youth, January 12th. Parakram Day, January 12th. National Girl Child Day, January. Then Republic Day, January 26th. Empowering girls in the state, making them aware of their rights and providing them equal opportunity. So again related to the girls, empowerment of girls. Punk Feather is a unique campaign for the protection, awareness, nutrition, knowledge and health of girls. Keep that in mind, Punk campaign related to empowerment of girls. Started on January 24th. Recently, Madhya Pradesh government celebrated 10 years of MP Public Service Guarantee Act. 10 years. It was passed in 2010. It's very important. MP Public Service Guarantee Act was passed in 2010. 10 years. What it aims? To bring about transparency in government functioning and make officials accountable for delay in delivery. Keep this fact in mind, it's very important. Rashtriya Bal Puraskar. Two children from Madhya Pradesh have been awarded with Rashtriya Bal Puraskar 2022. Who are they? The name Palak Sharma and Anuj Jain. Let's see what their category is. Palak Sharma under category sports is from Indore. Palak Sharma category sports from Indore, and she was chosen for Rashtriya Bal Puraskar from Madhya Pradesh. Also Anuj Jain, he belongs to the category scholastic and belongs to Hardar district. Bal Shakti Puraskar under Pradhan Mantri Rashtriya Bal Puraskar, the children with exceptional abilities, children with exceptional abilities are awarded with this award. Each award carries a medal, cash prize of 1 lakh rupees and certificate and citation. Keep the name of these two children in mind Palak Sharma and Anuj Jain. Very probable to come in examination. Now, very important regarding the Padma awardees from Madhya Pradesh. Padma Bhushan to Sumitra Mahajan. Padma Shri to two people, Kapil Tiwari and painter Srimati Bhuribai. Padma awards are Padma Shri, Padma Bhushan and Padma Vibhushan. Padma Bhushan was awarded to Srimati Sumitra Mahajan and Padma Shri to Kapil Tiwari and Srimati Bhuribai. Sumitra Mahajan, important fact about her, she is from MP Indore, 16th Speaker of the Lok Sabha 2014-19, 16th Speaker of the Lok Sabha, commonly known as Sai. She was preceded by Meera Kumar, if you are talking about this, and succeeded by Om Birla. She was also the Union Minister in Atal Bihari Vajpayee government 20 years back. Dr. Kapil Tiwari, he is related to folk culture. He is a folk culture expert. He is a former director of Madhya Pradesh Tribal Folk Art Academy. And he has contributed significantly to all round development of folk arts. So Kapil Tiwari, Padma Shri, related to folk culture and folk art. Just remember this point. Srimati Bhuribai, she is a Bhili painter. She's a painter. She presently works as an artist with MP Tribal Folk Academy, Bhopal. Where is this academy located? MP Tribal Folk Academy, located in Bhopal. And she belongs to Jhabua district. So Bhuribai, Bhili painter, belongs to Jhabua district, works in MP Tribal Folk Academy, Bhopal. So three personalities, very important for exam, Sumitra Mahajan, Kapil Tiwari and Bhuribai. Recently, 5-day Lok Rang ceremony was conducted in Ravindra Bhavan. It's 36th National Tribal and Folk Arts Festival organized on Republic Day at Ravindra Bhavan, Bhopal. And also the Bodh Dance was performed here. It was in news. It's a Bundeli folk dance, Bodh. It can also be asked in examination. Just keep in mind, Bodh is a Bundeli folk dance. Also, tribal artist Arjun Baghmare, he was in news. Why? Because our chief minister also honored Tatya tribal dancer, Sri Arjun Baghmare, recently. So he is a tribal dancer. Bhuribai was a painter. Just remember these names. It may be confusing, but just revise them. It will be easy for you to answer in exam. Ahar Anudan Yojana. It's related definitely ahar related to nutrition. But who are the beneficiaries? Our tribal people, tribal families. Who are they? Saharia, Bhaga and Bharia women specifically. An amount of 1,000 is transferred directly to the account of the female head of the family to improve the nutrition level of special backward classes and tribal people, Bhaga, Bharia and Saharia tribe. Under the Ahar Anudan Yojana, Ahar, it's related to the nutrition, but increasing the nutrition. Whom? So the targeted people are Saharia, Bhaga and Bharia. Let's see. Recently, automatic milk processing center was established at Sironj Sagar. It can be a one-liner question, it can come in examination. Just remember, automatic milk processing center at Sironj Sagar. What will happen here? Milk will be collected through cooperative societies from six nearby districts, Sagar, Chhatarpur, Panna, Damoh, Tikamgarh and New. And this plant will be the first automatic plant in Madhya Pradesh. Very probable to come in examination. Sironj Sagar, automatic milk processing center. National Commission of Women recently awarded COVID Women Warrior with name Nazira Khan. Sir, Anganwadi worker, Anganwadi worker Nazira Khan of Shiopur district, nominated for COVID Women Warrior Award by National Commission of Women. Just remember her name. You can see her name in coming examination. A small news related to solar power project inaugurated near Upper Lake in Bhopal, near VIP. It's just a single line fact. Just keep it in mind. Recently, regarding responsible tourism, Kerala is supporting Madhya Pradesh government. Why? Because Kerala has done this initiative in 2017 to ensure the economic well-being of society, social and cultural stability, and environmental protection. So now, after implementing this initiative in 2017, Kerala is now helping Madhya Pradesh government for the same, like responsible tourism. Who is the tourism minister in Madhya Pradesh government? Answer is Uta Thakur. Just see first which I am talking about. They are very much in frequent. I am not asking to but a complete list of ministers. But these are very frequent in news. It's very probable that they roadmap for Atmanirbhar Madhya Pradesh. I have told you in the earlier slide also. The roadmap for Atmanirbhar Madhya Pradesh designed with the help of IIM. This can come in examination. IIM Indore. Madhya Pradesh government signed MOU with MPIDC to build a roadmap to achieve MP's goal of Atmanirbhar Madhya Pradesh by 2023. We will deal in detail about Atmanirbhar Madhya Pradesh roadmap in the coming year. New education policy. Wipro again, we have seen that Wipro is open in Bhopal by Ajay Premji. Again, Wipro Group is set to act as the knowledge partner of the government of Madhya Pradesh in the context of new education policy at the implementation level. For the implementation of the new education policy in Madhya Pradesh, Wipro is going to act as a knowledge. And Wipro has taken an initiative to establish a university in Bhopal. We have seen this back in the this slide also. Through Ajim Premji Foundation. So Wipro only single point source for university, also acting as a knowledge partner and helping in implementation of education policy. Wipro is also establishing a software development center. Other than university, Wipro is also developing software development center in Bhopal. Ladli Lakshmi Yojana, too many times in bringing you some facts so that you can have clarity about it. Ladli Lakshmi Yojana, when I am talking about this initiation, it was initiated in 2007. Very basic question, it is coming next. When was this started? What is the objective? Developing a positive outlook among the people towards birth of a girl child, in targeting girl child, improving sex ratio, improving the educational level and health situation of girls, and laying the foundation for their good future. As the term suggests, Ladli Lakshmi, targeting girls and their well-being, okay, started in 2008. In 2018, on its line, Madhya Pradesh Ladli Lakshmi Girl Incentive Act 2018 has been implemented by the state government. Why? Because it provides guarantee for the amount of money given to each girl child so that the benefits provided to the girl child becomes permanent. So for the permanence of well-being and for the funds to provided to people on permanent basis, this part, the Madhya Pradesh Ladli Lakshmi Girl Incentive Act 2018 was passed. So the question can be asked that when was this act passed with the term Madhya Pradesh Ladli Lakshmi Girl Incentive Act? Answer would be 2018. When was the scheme started? 2007. Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao, when was it started? 2007. Bhamashah Yojana is related to honest taxpayers. Swanidhi is related to vendors. So again and again I am revising terms so that you keep that in mind. It will be for you to remember. And this scheme has been revisited given the form of E-Laadli since May 2015. It's also a fact that this scheme was revisited after 2007 in 2015 and with the form of E-Laadli. Who are the beneficiaries? The Women and Child Development Department pays rupees 2000 to eligible beneficiaries of the scheme, rupees 4000 on admission class 9th, rupees 6000 for admission class 11th and 12th, and 1 lakh on completion of 21. But the condition is the girl child will receive e-payment of rupees 1 lakh on completion of 21 years of age and on the condition that girl does not get married before the age of 18 and has appeared in class 12th exam. These are the criteria for getting cash support. Young entrepreneurs to get skill development training in solar energy technology. Recently, this was in some young people. Only 10 are to be trained from each, and this training to be imparted by Professor Chetan Singh Solanki. And asked in the examination that Professor Chetan Singh was related to skill development program for young entrepreneurs related to solar technology. Belongs from IIT Bombay, founder of Energy Swaraj Foundation and brand ambassador of solar energy in Madhya Pradesh at RGTU Bhopal. Brand ambassador of solar energy in Madhya Pradesh, RGTU, Professor Chetan Singh Solanki. Just keep that in mind. One important aspect is regarding bamboo production in Madhya Pradesh. It was in news many times. Madhya Pradesh bamboo production units, the grant of over rupees 1 crore 22 lakh has been issued to 9 bamboo producing units sanctioned for bamboo products to increase the income of bamboo growing farmers in Madhya Pradesh. In 2021, a target has been set to establish 32 bamboo based units in state. It's a mission target set for 2021. Again, who is the forest minister? Kuvar Vijay Shah. He was in news frequently. Just remember, Kuvar Vijay Shah. And Madhya Pradesh is the only state in the country where the work of bamboo production unit has started now. Madhya Pradesh is the only state in the country where the work of bamboo production unit started. 2021, the target is for 32 bamboo based units. Recently, the grant of over 1 crore for 9 bamboo production units already sanctioned. National Bamboo Mission. It's a very important fact. National Bamboo Mission is to promote the growth of bamboo sector. Restructured National Bamboo Mission launched in 2018-19. And this mission was launched as a natural corollary of historic amendment of Indian Forest Act 2017. What is bamboo called as? It is called as poor man's timber. Very important question. Frequently asked in all the examinations, what is called as poor man's timber? Answer is bamboo. State Bamboo Mission in Madhya Pradesh. State Bamboo Mission started in 2013. India has world's 20% of the bamboo resources, and Madhya Pradesh has 20% of the area and 12% of the growing stock of. Recently, next topic is Shivraj Singh Chauhan distributed compensation amount to landowners of Betma Pithampur. Landowners compensation to the landowners of Betma Pithampur. Where is Betma? Betma is in Indore district, and Pithampur, just remember, Pithampur is not in Indore district. Pithampur is in Dhar district. Very confusing fact, and friends get confused very frequently. Madhya Pradesh rewarded for completing 3 out of 4 citizen-centric reform. Recently, the financial assistance of 1,004 crore was given by Finance Minister, by Nirmala Sitharaman, under scheme of special assistance states for capital expenditure. Why they are assisting us? Because we have completed 3 out of 4 citizen centric reforms, Madhya Pradesh government. And what are those reforms? One nation, one ration card reforms, ease of doing business reforms, urban local body reforms, and power sector reforms. Keep this in mind that Madhya Pradesh rewarded recently for completing 3 out of 4 citizen. We got the aid from finance. That's it. Recently, our senior journalist Shri Sushil Tiwari passed away, and he was related to the Dainik Bhaskar group. It's related to the personality section. 2021 digital diary and calendar on New Year's occasion, CM released new digital diary and calendar. Okay, in place of the hard copy, CM released digital diary and calendar for the year 2021. Chief Justice appointment, Chief Justice of Madhya Pradesh High Court, Shri Mohammad Rafi. Date is very important. He took oath on 3rd of January as the new Chief Justice of Madhya Pradesh High Court. The oath taking ceremony was held at Sandipani Auditorium, Raj Bhavan. Chief Justice of Madhya Pradesh High Court, Mohammad Rafi, took oath on 3rd of January. Very important date, can be asked in examination. Miss Madhya Pradesh Rudra Priya Yadav. Name can be seen in the examination paper. Rudra Priya Yadav, very important to remember. She is Miss Madhya Pradesh. She is Femina Miss India, Miss MP 2020. Rudra Priya Yadav, and she is preparing and representing Madhya Pradesh for All India pageant. Sushri Rudra Priya currently serves as a research associate in School of Planning and Architecture. Remember her name, Rudra Priya Yadav, representing Madhya Pradesh. CM congratulated PM for being ranked number 1 in the world in approval rating. Recently, a survey was conducted for the approval rating, and our Prime Minister, Shri Narendra Modi, came out at the top, number 1 approval rating with highest number of supporters in the world, 5%. Chancellor of Germany, Angela Merkel, approval rating was 24%. One more fact related to sports, Syed Mushtaq Ali Trophy 2020 tournament, it was held at Dohr. Just remember, single line of fact. So it's done for today. We have covered so many facts related to sports, related to schemes, for places, personalities. Everything is covered in the today's lecture. We will come with more lectures in the coming series, in this series of MP Current Affairs. In the meantime, you can download our app, MPPSC Adda, from Google Play Store. You can download it and check out the store section at the bottom. All the courses are listed there for prelims examination, for current affairs, for mains examination, for test series, and everything. You can check the courses like 30 mock tests, test series with current affairs. Notes of prelims are also available there, and current affairs of Madhya Pradesh is also available. On our website, mppscadda.com, you can also visit there and check out the courses like prelims test series, full pack, notes, current affairs, as well as mains test series. Thank you very much for the today's session. We are also launching current affairs series related to national, international, sports, science, personalities, places. Stay tuned to us. That series is also, we are starting, and it will be released tomorrow. Thank you for the session. All the best.